Good evening. My name is Hayoung Jeong, and I'm a first-year conducting student in the master program. We open tonight concert with a ballad in A minor by Samuel Coleridge Taylor. He was a British composer born in London in 1875. He was of mixed race with an English mother and an African father, which was quite rare for the time. Despite facing racial prejudice, he showed remarkable talent from a young age and received formal training at the Royal College of Music. Coleridge Taylor's compositions often reflected his African heritage, blending elements of Western classical music with African themes and rhythms. Coleridge Taylor's ballad is simply captivating. It packed with so much feelings and these amazing melodies that stick in your head. The way he mixes up different sounds and emotions in the music is like nothing else. Listening to it feels like you're diving into the deep musical story that just grabs hold of you. Thank you and enjoy.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Oliver Chen, and I'm a second-year orchestra conducting student. This evening, I'll be presenting you Zemslinsky's Sinfonietta. A lot of you probably don't know who Zemslinsky is, and definitely don't know this piece. Zemslinsky was a late 19th century, early 20th century composer, and in fact, he was a very important musical figure in Europe, especially in Germany and Vienna. He taught a lot of important musicians, including Korngold and Arnold Schoenberg. When he was a student, Johannes Brahms recognized his talent and actually recommended his works to be published by his own publisher. He was an important composer, very experimental, and in fact, he also his orchestration had a lot of similarities with Mahler, very lush harmonies, colorful orchestration, and long melodic lines. Besides being an amazing composer, he was also a very, very good conductor. So he worked with Mahler, and he also worked with Otto Klemperer, and he got positions at very prestigious opera houses and orchestras, including the Crow Opera, Vienna Volksopera, and Vienna Stadtoper. So just a little bit drama to share with you. Before Alma Mahler married Gustav Mahler, he was dating Zemslinsky, so some drama right there, conductor's drama. So a little bit more about this piece. This is actually his last orchestral work. Three movements. First movement sounds a little bit more Viennese. Second movement sounds more Mahler. And third movement is actually probably one of the most contrapuntal work you can find for orchestral pieces. So I hope you enjoy this program. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. beginning of the second half is a piece from Samuel Barber called Knoxville, Summer of 1915. It was written in 1947, and it describes a daydreaming, a story of a little child that wakes up, and you'll get this from the music, that wakes up, becomes an adult, and then he goes back and becomes a child again. And the two, the piece was inspired by James H. He was the poet. And so the two guys, Samuel Barber and James H., meet. The common ground is the love for the father. So you will also hear that in the story. We are very pleased to welcome Melanie Athans, that she will be our soloist. She was the winner of the concerto competition last year. So please welcome Melanie Athans, and this is your orchestra.
People in Paris are its gold windows and straw seats on past and past and past. Licks the crackling and hissing above it like a small malignant spirit set to dog its tracks. The iron wine rises on rising speed, still risen faints, haunts the faint Time of trial.
right, our final piece for this evening was written a long time ago, 220 years, so 1806. And you might be going, oh, I kind of recognize the Barber, but finally now Beethoven, there's a piece I know. Well, this is the least performed of his 9 symphonies. It sort of stands as this gem between, you know, the very pivotal 3rd and 5th symphonies. So the 4th is often overlooked, and for that reason not done a lot, but it has so much to offer. There's grace, there's lyricism, and there are sparkly textures, and it's also hard to play. So, but I've been very proud of my previous and current conducting students who have done a phenomenal job this evening. And it's also not easy for an orchestra to, to adjust to 4 different approaches to conducting. So I hope you enjoy Beethoven's sparkly 4th symphony.
Thank you.